just have to show you guys this coffee. We got this coffee at Costco. It's Vanilla Nut Jose's Gourmet Coffee. There's 48 ounces in here, and I believe we got it for around $13, maybe $14. We were gonna get the McCafe, like premium roast, whatever, but it was like $18. And this one is so delicious, vanilla nut, and it was cheaper for more, so couldn't pass up on savings like that. Look at that. I wish you guys could smell this. This is like heaven in a bag. I wish I could video this glorious smell and you guys be able to smell it. So delicious. Good morning, everyone. Today is Monday, March 16th, and I don't have too much going on today, just work and lifting, but I wanted to show you some meals that I just prepped. I just have chicken, sweet potato, and broccoli, and actually the same meal for this one as well. I really don't mind eating the same thing as long as I enjoy it, so that's what I'm eating today. And then I got that same hot sauce that I'm always using. I found this one at Ralph's, which I think is the equivalent of Kroger in Texas. And here it's just called Smoky Chipotle Pepper Hot Sauce. It's so good, and it only has 50 milligrams of sodium. So if you're on prep or something, that's a really good option to kind of spice up your foods. So bringing my pre-workout stacks so that as soon as I get done with work, I can take these and hit the gym. I'm gonna be working out legs and glutes today. So hopefully I'll get an exercise or two recorded. But if not, then I'll record the next one that I do. But my shoulder is killing me from Saturday's shoulder workout, so I'm gonna go ahead and go. This selfie mode is not working very well. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I will talk to you later. Bye. Today I wasn't able to record my whole workout, but I did get the last two exercises recorded for you. Here is just a reverse lunge on a step. I am holding a dumbbell at my chest. Basically just a really deep lunge, pushing through the heel at the top and contracting that glute with a slight hip extension at the top. So really just squeezing all the way through. My glutes were on fire, so even just this little amount of weight was killing me at the end. Today is Tuesday, March 17th, and it is back day. This is the ISO hammer strength row. I was doing a 45-pound plate and a 25-pound plate on each side. This is my sixth set, and it felt really great. During this back day, I was really focusing on the negative or eccentric part of each movement. So I actually sped up most of these videos just for the sake of time, but really just focusing on the eccentric movement, and it worked. I was so incredibly sore for the next few days and still kind of feel my lats. So it was successful. I really like
working on different portions of the movement. Some days just lifting really, really heavy. Other days not lifting as heavy, but focusing on, you know, different portions of the movement like today. So this is just another, it's another row, an underhand grip row. And I was doing the same thing here, but like I said, the video is sped up, so you can't really tell that I'm doing the negative part. But I'm gonna let the rest of this play out, and I hope you guys enjoy this workout footage. I just got to 24 Hour Fitness. Today is Wednesday, March 18th. Today is plyos and cardio. So I feel my pre-workout kicking in. I feel good. So I'm going to go ahead and go in there and hopefully have a really good workout. And if I can record something, I'll include it. If not, I'll see you guys tomorrow. For today's plyo workout, my main goal was pretty much to die, but to never stop moving. So what I did really was, you'll always see me doing something a little bit easier followed by something a little harder. So you saw there I did a jog followed by pretty much a sprint. There's not too much room here, so I didn't really get to full speed, but same thing here. You see me doing frog jumps, and then after going there and back frog jumps, I do lunge kickbacks. In another portion you'll see, I believe I did squat jumps followed by some pull squats. So anytime that I was feeling completely out of breath and dying, I generally did something like a jog or a squat or a slowed lunge like this, just something to keep my heartbeat going but to never stop the whole time. So I did quite a few sets of this before going in and doing some more isolated glute work, and I'll just let you guys watch the rest of it, and I hope you enjoy it. To my heartbeats. And I met you in the summer. To my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon.
Wednesday, March 19th, and I feel really good today. Today is supposed to be just cardio for me, so usually I'll do like 30 minutes of cardio and then some stretching, foam rolling, whatever. But I feel really good today. I don't feel like my body needs a break, so I'm not going to take one. I'm going to do my cardio as planned and then hit some shoulders as well. So that's it. That's the game plan for my training today. Meals are going really great. I haven't been showing you guys many meals recently. I feel like I'm boring. I don't know. I just have chicken and then I brought an entire thing of broccoli. I eat it raw most of the time, but I've been just putting it in the microwave for 2 minutes with the top just barely cracked, and it's like steamed broccoli. I know you're all like, wow, genius, we've been doing that for a century, but I don't know, it's really good. Change up for my raw broccoli. So that's what's on the meal plan for today. That's what's training today. I'll see if I can get something recorded, but if not, I'll see you guys tomorrow. I plan on updating you on week 3 of prep tomorrow. So I'm really excited. My diet and everything starts getting a lot more strict. This Saturday I'll be 9 weeks out and 10 weeks out. And then next Saturday starts the 8 week out mark. And that's really where I've got to like really hone in everything, really condition everything. So
it's so pretty outside today. I just had to show you. It's all sunny. The skies are blue. Time to go work out soon.
So I just got off of work. I'm going to go home and let the boys out, feed them, play with them, love on them for at least an hour, maybe 2 hours. That's why I'm always at the gym so late, because when I get off, I have no choice but to go home. And then once I get there, I can't put them right back in their kennels. So the struggle of being a fur baby mom. Anyways, I am playing this fun little game called Let's See How Far Emily Can Get on Empty. And so far, I've almost made it home. So hopefully I get all the way home. I guess you guys will find out if I'm stranded on the side of the road. We'll see. So it's Thursday, about 8:15 at night. I got home around 7, and then I fed the boys, threw their ball for them, loved on them a little bit, and usually I try to stay for like 2 hours after I get home to, just because like they've been in the kennel all day, and I feel like a bad mom, and I miss them and feel bad for them because they've been in their kennel. I say all day, it's really only been like 5-6 hours, but still I just feel bad. So yeah, I only stayed about an hour today, but I think they're gonna be fine. I'm gonna go knock this workout out and then come back and hang out with them and then start editing footage. I think I have a good amount for this next week. I somehow deleted like half the footage that I had, from Saturday and Sunday, and I had a lot of stuff. So I was really disappointed with that, and it ended up in me not vlogging for like a whole day because I was so upset and mad at technology in the world. But I'm better now, so I'm back to trying to vlog as much as I can. And that's about it for right now. I'm going to go hit shoulders and cardio, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay, sorry the lighting is so awful, but I had to update you guys. First, on the game that we're playing, not only did I make it all the way home, but I've now made it to the gym, which is like one little city over, one exit down the road. So hopefully I make it back home. We'll find out. Brandon, don't be mad. I promise I won't stall out. Also, I need to like reread the label ingredient list on Megawatt HD because every single time I take it, I just like randomly start smiling, and I swear it's not a coincidence. Like, I'm not that happy. And then I'm happy. I'm a happy person, but like I take Megawatt HD and I'm just like, ah. And then I was driving, and I'm wearing this ugly bun on my head, which you can barely see, but it's huge. And so I'm driving, and then all of a sudden I see this huge thing in my rear view mirror, like someone's head. And so I flipped out. I was like, ah! And like my heart dropped. And then all of a sudden I was like, Emily, that's your own bun. So yeah, with that said, I'm going to go hit shoulders and cardio now. Okay, it is so funny for me to go back and watch this footage. I was so amped on pre-workout. Anyways, this is basically like an upright row, but laying down. I'm using the area where you would normally do a cable row for your back.
I'm just laying down using a straight bar and performing it like I would an upright row. I really like this because you never get full extension at the bottom there, so your elbows never go straight. So there's always constant contraction on that front delt, and it gives it a really good pump and makes it burn really bad. This is another variation of an upright row on cables. I'm standing on the smallest box that they have, just so that I can get full extension at the end there. And on this one, I was just focusing on the negative, so doing the reps as slow as humanly possible, and it was burning every second of the way. I guess today was the day of the upright rows or something. I was doing every variation imaginable. Maybe I was just avoiding triceps, I'm not sure.
So tired of me by now, but I had Brandon look at the ingredient label of Megawatt HD, and there's actually dendrobium in it. Dendrobium makes you feel like euphoric, maybe a little high, which is probably the reason why I'm always smiling when I'm on it. So if you haven't tried it, you need to try it. It's amazing. It always makes me sweat a ton, but also makes me really happy. So if you want to be happy, try some of this.
All right, everyone, this is my progress picture for the week. I threw my stats up there, but I really don't care that they're not changing. I see my body changing, and that's what's important. That is going to conclude this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And if you enjoyed watching the video, please press the like button and also subscribe to my channel. I am so sorry that this video was so long. I had some problems this week. I had some deleted footage, so I felt like I didn't have anything. And then I went on this binge recording where I recorded everything, so then I had a ton. I'm gonna try and figure it out better so that I can space things out better, maybe do 2 videos a week so that it's not so long. And I figured out that I can record on my phone, which is a lot easier for me, so I think I'm gonna start doing that. It'll make it easier for more of the vlog type stuff rather than just filming my workouts. So if you guys have any suggestions or comments or anything that you want to leave below, I would really appreciate it. I really appreciate any feedback that you give me. And thank you again so much for watching. I hope you all have a great week, and I will see you guys next week for week 4 of prep. The rest of this video has absolutely nothing to do with bikini prep. It's just me messing around on the piano. I used to play piano for years, and it's kind of just another form of therapy for me. So I hope you enjoy it if you watch the rest of the video, and if not, I'll see you in the next one.